Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Dentistified. In this video, I'll tell you why the anterior guidance is important while restoring the occlusion of the patient. I hope you have already watched my previous two videos where I have explained in detail the concept of anterior guidance. But a quick overview for those who have not watched that. Anterior guide angle is the angle which is formed by the horizontal plane of occlusion and a line in the sagittal plane between the incisal edges of the maxillary and mandibular central incisors when the teeth are in maximum intercuspation, as you can see in this picture. And such arrangement of anterior teeth resulting in posterior disocclusion is highly desirable. And this is what is referred to as anterior guidance. Okay. Now let's talk about the importance of anterior guidance. The anterior guidance plays a very important role in establishing the functional path that the mandible can travel. Therefore, anterior guidance is one of the vital factors that should be taken into consideration while restoring the occlusion of the patient. Right? Lack of sufficient understanding about anterior guidance would result in guesswork, and guessing at the position, inclination or contour of anterior teeth is not only time consuming but it is frustrating too, both for the dentist as well as for the patient. You know, next to centric relation, the anterior guidance is the most important factor to be considered while restoring an occlusion. And I've already talked in detail about centric relation in my previous videos. In case you missed out those videos, make sure to go through those videos, okay, in order to understand the topic better. I'll provide the links for those videos in the description box. So, the correctness of anterior guidance determines the success or failure of many occlusal treatments. So, the next thing is that before attempting to restore the anterior teeth, every dentist should know that besides aiding in mastication, phonation, and aesthetics, the anterior teeth also play a key role in protecting the posterior teeth. And how the anteriors protect the posteriors? It is by the process called posterior disocclusion. I hope that by now you all understand that what is a process of posterior disocclusion. So as I've already stated that whenever a patient performs protrusive or lateral excursive movements, contacts remain only on the anterior teeth, while all the posterior teeth, they disocclude. That means there is separation of all the posterior teeth. And this separation further results in shutting down of almost all of the elevator muscles. So this is what we call as the posterior disocclusion. And this further reduces the chances of overloading or excessive wear of the posterior teeth, right? So what will happen if there is lack of adequate anterior guidance? So when there is lack of adequate anterior guidance, it would result in occlusal interferences in the posterior teeth, which are highly undesirable. Why? Because such occlusal interferences may cause muscle hyperactivity and hence generating excessive forces not only on teeth and restorations, but also on the temporomandibular joints, on the TMJs. Now the correct anterior guidance ensures the long-term stability of the entire dentition. And how does it ensure the long-term stability of the entire dentition? Because when the anterior guidance is correct, it eliminates almost all the chances of anterior bone loss or anterior tooth mobility and tooth wear, provided that there are no susceptible periodontal tissues and no excessive forces are there. And anterior guidance is also the principal determinant of posterior tooth morphology or the posterior occlusal form. And in case if you want to know that what is the role of anterior guidance in determining the cuspal form of posterior teeth, then do check out the link of that video, which I'll provide in the bottom bar. That video explains that why the anterior guidance should be taken into consideration while selecting the posterior teeth for removable partial dentures or fixed partial dentures. So that's it for today. I hope you found this video helpful, and you'll definitely incorporate the concept of anterior guidance while planning the treatment for restoration of a patient's occlusion. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in my next video. Stay tuned for that. This video, do hit that like button and share this video with your friends and spread the knowledge. Make sure that you are subscribed to this channel, Dentistified, if you haven't already. And if you don't want to miss out any of my videos in future, do press that bell icon which is next to the subscribe button so that you will get notified each time I upload a new video. Till then, take care. I'll see you soon in my next video.